another video about Elvira. I took her house out. And I'm going to attempt to try to feed her. So now, she's in her log. I don't think you're going to be able to see. She's in there, but I'm going to pull her log out. Can't even see her tail. Maybe a little bit. So, I'm going to try to pull this out with one hand. And of course, she's clung on there. Pretty girl. She's still really skittish. So, I just gotta try to move slow and do this through the camera at the same time. See, she's kind of scared right now because she's not even smelling. But she will eventually. She's better after playing with her for a few minutes. Now, I'm just gonna touch her tail. Let's see, she's tensing up. She'll probably try to run. Turn the light on, maybe you can see a little better. So, I'm gonna try to pick her up. And I just lightly pick her up like this. That way she knows she can run away if she wants. And now she's running to where her burrow used to be. Now she's moving around a lot more. Smelling. I just want her to get the smell me. She might also smell the worms I pulled out for her. Try to go under again. Just kind of lift her up a little bit. You want to say hello? She is being pretty good the last couple of days. And then she runs. She might be a little camera shy. She is a little jumpy, but I'm familiar that I think my life is consistent. She's not too bad. When we first got her, she was real skittish. Now she's gonna try to dig. Surprisingly, the scratches on my hand are not from her. They're actually from that little guy. Yeah. Who happens to be a little bastard. Okay, where'd you go? I'm gonna try to pick her up one more time, make sure she can see me. Oh. Let me try to right on top view. Come on. See, I just keep going underneath her. And letting her know that she, at any time, can climb down. That still doesn't mean we're not going to have any issues with hissing and running around. She's very flighty. She's also shedding right now, as you can see. This is her digging, trying to get away, I guess. She does dig in her burrow anyway. She's got a slab that goes on top of there. But she likes to dig in there anyway. I normally dig it nice and deep, and then she digs in the sides. And normally they're not supposed to like to be exposed. But she likes to dig holes in the sides of her burrow, and then she can see out. But you just gotta reassure that you're not going to hurt her. And the sooner she realizes that, the calmer she'll get. And eventually, she'll get calm enough to the point where I can hold her up, and then she falls asleep. Wondering if I can rest the camera here. Still be able to see everything. Ah, there we go. Yeah, let's see if I can get it up a little bit higher. There we go. Yeah, not the ideal thing I'd like to do with my cell phone, but you know. She's being very good. So to give her a worm. Now, I've yet to try to feed by hand, but you know, as a first for everything. Yeah, she doesn't seem overly interested, but I guarantee if I drop it, she'll eat it. Good thing I didn't grab that with my hand.
She does really like worms. I think I'm on my last one now. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, I got a little one. I think this one's a trout worm. Nah, she might have had enough of the worms. Okay, that's all the worms I got. But I do have some wax worms, which I've never given her one yet. I don't know what she'll do with the wax worm. I don't think she's gonna go for a wax worm. Yeah, I don't think so. But that doesn't mean I don't have something else. One second, I'll be right back. Now, I've got a little piece of beef she didn't eat from the other day, and she really liked the beef. But that was the last part of the beef that I happen to have. The other thing I have, which it was not yesterday, the day before, tried giving her, a little bit of fish. This is actually salmon, which, yes, she really likes salmon. Want the little piece? That was probably the most gentle she's ever taken anything from me. You gotta let go. Okay, there. Oop. There you go. She's actually being a very good right now. This is probably the best she's actually been. When we first got her, she was very, very underweight. And we finally got her up to a reasonable size. But she's normally not this good when it comes to eating. I think she's trying to get that piece down. But normally, she's not this good when it comes to eating. She's usually, whoop. Normally speaking, she don't like eating out of the tongs. She don't like doing a lot. She's very picky. But she's definitely doing very good today. She's working that piece down now. Now she's probably gonna back up and knock the camera over. Yep. You don't want any more? There's nobody else here, it's just me and you. She might be done eating. She's eating a lot right now. Whoop, and knocked the camera over. Try one more time. Nah, she might be done eating. Yeah, I think she's all done. Seems like every time I pull food out for her, she goes to eat, she always happens to leave, like, just one piece. One little piece left. Can I have my phone? Please? There we go. So she's getting used to me. She's probably mad right now because I pulled her hidey hole out. But she is slowly getting used to me. I'm going to try to set the camera up over by her water bowl, which I'm having a feeling is a bad idea. But we'll try it. See, she's being very good right now and running away. But compared to when we first got her, like I said, she was very underweight and very skittish. Really didn't like people whatsoever. But she's come a long way. It's to the point I can actually pick her up now. And eventually she will calm down. But like I said, it has been a long process to this. She's shedding a lot now. She didn't like her legs being touched. But no, she is good. So,
after I put her house back together, maybe I'll do another video, but I think we're gonna try a little more bonding and then put it all back together. Okay, so I put her log back and I just want to test to see if she'll try to run after now that her log's back. I've been playing with her for a good half hour, 45 minutes. I don't have any tongue flicking, which is not necessarily a good thing. But last half hour, 45 minutes, I've been picking her up, giving her a little scratch. As you see, I've successfully got a fair amount of shed off. And she wants to dig. She likes digging. But yeah, she's not entirely psycho like a... Not entirely psycho like that one. What are you doing? Throwing quite a bit of dirt. Come on. Come on. Stop doing that. Stop doing that. Stop burying your head. Just get awfully dark in here. Why are you gonna be so antisocial? I think she's camera shy. I can pick her up pretty high, but she's not the world's biggest fan of it. I still go very, very slow when I go to touch her. Because she's still very unsure. I don't know what she thinks. I just try to turn her around. I'm just gonna hide in the dark. Okay, I do have to put your house back together, so if you don't mind, see, now I'm going to attempt to put her house back for like the 400th time. She always likes to tear her house back apart, which is all right. She loves her log. She almost can't fit in her log. I was too busy looking at her. But I'd be willing to bet she's gonna run right into her basking spot. I'm taking my drum lights back on. Mm-hmm. see, that's our burrow there. Nice piece of slate, which gets super, super hot. But there's our enclosure for now. Till we build the much bigger one, which is gonna wind up being like a good portion of my living room. But she's still small, so it's a good size for her. Fresh water. Definite must. I swear to God, I feel like a slave changing her water every day. I change that at least 5 times a day. Ugh. But very relatively clean. She tends to do her business in her tub of water. But, so it's not that big of a deal to clean it every so often. But that's Elvira. Say goodbye, Elvira.
No. Can't even see in there. Well, I'm sure she's hoping I go away. Alright. Check in maybe a little bit later.
So, I almost forgot the most important part of our playtime is her quail egg. She absolutely loves quail eggs. And, yeah, loves these silly things. Surprisingly, they sell these at the grocery store, which I was not aware of. But, so I'll put that right there, the opening of her hole.
I don't know if we're going to be able to see in there. Yeah, definitely not. Yeah. But nevertheless, she's in there. And her head, I believe, is facing this end.
So, I'm just going to put her quail egg right here. Make some noise so she looks. And leave that for her. But okay, so now that is all. I'll probably check in tomorrow or day after. Give her a little bit of a break today. All right. Bye, guys.